Hello everyone, my name is Prithviraj. This is the third video on ALP programming for ARM 7. Let's start. In the previous videos, we have seen the addition of two 32-bit numbers. In this video, we are going to take up some of new instructions. Now, I will open this Keel software. This was where we have left in the previous video. Now, I am going to cancel this editor here and also this one here and also this one. Now I'm going to create a new file. Now I'm going to introduce you to a new instruction called as LSL, that is logical shift left, LSL. The first syntax of logical left shift is this one, that is LSL is an instruction. This is a register, this is a next register, and this is an immediate value of 5-bit, that is it can accept 5-bit as the maximum number. I am now going to demonstrate this on a Keel software. Now I am going to write a program for it. Remember that I use capital letters everywhere in the code as the coding standards. You can use the file name, that is the second field which I am writing now, in small letters. I have written the code now. I am going to save it as Ctrl S. Remember, the file extension should be .s. Now I have saved the file. I am going to add this one to the source group by right clicking here, adding this one and clicking .s here and lsl1.s, add, close. Now I am going to compile this. Here you can see that is one error and one warning, and the error has been occurred in the fourth line as given here. This is because I forgot that I should put equal to sign for LDR, which I have told you in the previous video. I am going to save it by pressing Ctrl S and again going to rebuild it. Now there is a zero error and zero warning. Here you can see the LSL instruction has been used. I will explain you how does this work. The LDR instruction will copy this 2 to R1, means it will transfer the value of 2 to R1, and LSL will shift left the R1 value by one time and store it in R2. This is the destination register, this is the source register, and this is the how much time the LSL should be applied to R1. Now I am going to debug and start debug session. I am going to press F11. This 2 has been come to R1 here, and I am going to press F11 again. You can see that the 2 has been shifted by 1 time. I am going to show this by expanding the each digit over here into 32-bit. This is 32-bit equivalent of 2. When it is shifted 1 time left side, this 1 will come over here. That time the value of this one will be 4. That's why it is showing here 4, and the rest of the values will be zeros. It has shifted one time left and the value has been changed. Basically, the left shift operation is multiply the number in the register by 2. How many times you left shift the value, that many times you should multiply by 2. Now I am going to stop the debug session, and I am going to change this value to 2. I am going to save this and compile this. I am going to start the debug session. F11. You can see here that the value in the register R1 has been multiplied by 2 times. That is 2 raised to 2. 4 into 2. That is 8. So 8 has been stored in R2. Now I am going to stop the debug session. So this LSL of this syntax has a limitation. You can give the maximum number up to 31, above which you cannot give it. Here I am going to compile this. Zero errors and zero warnings. I am going to rebuild this. Here I am going to press F11 and F11. Here you can see nothing has been come up for R2. This is because the bit 1 has been shifted left such a way that it has been taken away from the register. Now I am going to show you that one. Here you can see that is this whole thing, which are up to here, that is 30 bits. For 31 bit, this 1 has been taken away from here. So that's why it is showing us the 0 in R2. If this is 1, I am going to build it, compile it and start the debug session. F11. See that 1 has been come to the last position. That is, if this was 1, 31 bit shift will take this 1 to the last position over here, which will give you the 8 in this position, and in rest of the position it will be 0. When LSL is done 2 times, this will be the output. That is 31 bit shift. I am going to start the debug session. Now I will try to give the greater number than 31, that is 32. I am going to save this and compile this. See, the error has been occurred, saying that this is the maximum limit, 0 to 31. So 31 is the maximum limit for this type of a syntax. This is another syntax for LSL. I am going to try this one right here in KEEL. This one is the short form of the instruction which I am going to write in front of this by giving a comment. Comment is given by this colon: LSL R1, hash immediate. That is the previous one. But this R1, which are same, that can be written like this. That is, this is the source which has to be shifted for this many times, and this is the destination where the value has to be stored, which you can see over here also. This is the source which has to be shifted this many times, which has to be specified by the programmer and has to be stored over here. This works same as that of the previous instruction. See, the value of R1 has been changed itself. There is no original value of R1 available right now. I am going to stop the debug session now. You can use here the hexadecimal values also. That is 0x1. It also works for the hexadecimal values. See, 0 errors and 0 warnings as same way as the decimal values. But the maximum limit for this is the same as 31, which hexa equivalent is 1f. This is the maximum value. It does not give any error. If we exceed this, the next number after this is 20. When compiled, it will show the error. It also takes the hexa value. What happens if you give the 0 over here? Nothing happens. The number in the register remains the same. You can try it by compiling it and starting the debug session. It also remains same when you give the hexa 0 over here. The one more variation of LSL instruction is, this is the one more variation of LSL. Now we are going to see the working of this one. I am going to write the code according to the instruction LDR. I am going to take one more register R2 and I am going to save 2 in it. And now I am going to use R2 over here. Now this is the variation. That is, R1 has to be left shifted R2 times and is to be stored in R1. Now I am going to delete this one. Now I am going to save this and build this. Zero errors and zero warnings. Now I am going to start the debug session. See, 1 has been taken in R1 and 2 has been taken in R2. Then R1 is shifted 2 times. That is, R1 is multiplied by 4. Therefore, R1 value is 4 over here right now. The value of R2 has the limit same as that of the LDR. That is, the value of R2 can vary from -2^31 to 2^31 -1. But if the value of R2 is greater than 32, then all the bit will be 0 for any number. You take any number in R1 and give the number greater than 32. It will shift the number 32 times, which makes all the bits 0. That is, if any of this number is shifted 32 times, then all will be occupied by 0. Therefore, giving the value of R2 greater than 32 is meaningless. This was one of the variation of LSL instruction. The other variation of this instruction is, this is the other variation of above instruction. This is the destination, this is a source register, and this is the register which contains the values that how much times this register has to be shifted left, and it is stored in RD. Let me show you this. This is R1 and let the R2 value be 2. Then I can give here R3, R1, R2. This means R1 value, that is 1, has to be left shifted R2 times, that is 2 times, and is to be stored in R3. I will save this and rebuild it and start the debug session. When I press F11, you can see that R1 has 1 and R2 has 2. Now R1 is left shifted 2 times, that is, it is multiplied by 2 2 times, which becomes 4, and it is stored in R3 as the destination. When I press F11, you can see that 4 has been stored here. That LSL is nothing but multiplying a number by 2. The number of shift is equal to number of times the number is multiplied by 2. These were the 4 variations of logical left shift. But in the ARM instruction set, which I am going to give in the description box below, that has been issued by ARM company, there are only 2 standard instructions. That is, this the first one and the third one. These 2 instruction sets are not mentioned in the instruction set copy that is given by ARM company. So in upcoming videos, I will be dealing with only those instructions which are specified in the instruction set manual. The link for the instruction set manual will be given in the description box below. I will be referring for the first link, which has been taken from the SLOS textbook. This is it for LSL instruction. Now we will move on to LSR instruction, that is logical shift right. The syntax for LSR instruction is this one. It is same as that of LSL, that is this one. See, this one is same for LSR, that is shift right. And the shift right is nothing but divide the number by 2. As there was in shift left, multiply by 2. In shift right, it is divide by 2. Let me demonstrate this in kill. I'm going to stop the debug session. R2 is my destination register, R1 is the source register, and I want to shift it right. I should change this to LSR. Shift it right by 1 time. And I am going to change this value to 2. That is, the value in R1 is shifted right by 1 time and is stored in R2. I am going to save this and build it. 0 error, 0 warning. I am going to start the debug session. F11, F11. R2 has 2 and R1 has 1. The R2 has been shifted 1 time. Let me show you here. When this is 2, this is the 32 bit. When it is shifted right by 1 time, this 1 will be shifted here and 0 will be added at this end, which becomes like this, which is equal to 1. Therefore, the R2 has 1 after right shifting 2 by 1 time. This one has the same limitations as that of LSL, that is 31. The other syntax for this one is also same as that of LSL. Only change is this last L. So you can try with that one. Now we will add an S over here and see how it affects the condition flag. Let me show you. I'm going to change it to LSL and S. This S is added because we have to affect the CPSR register. That is, if the carry comes, then it should be indicated in CPSR register. So we add S over here. This does not give any carry because after multiplying this 2 by 2, it becomes 4. So that 4 can be represented in 32 bits. So there will be no carry. But when I give here 31, save it, I will rebuild it, and I am going to start the debug session. When I press F11, here you can see that R2 has been shifted 31 times. That is, 1 has been taken away from the bits, which I have shown you earlier. If 1 is shifted 31 times, it will be taken out of the 32 bits. Therefore, the register will be holding 0. That is how the 2 has zeros in it. And that 1 has been taken away to a carry bit, that is carry flag. And R2 is 0 over here. So the 0 flag and the carry flag are set to 1. That is how it is 6. I will take you to the content of CPSR register. Here you can see when C becomes 1 and Z becomes 1, the total value of this 4 bit is 6. This carry flag is affected due to shifting, and this 0 flag is affected because R2 has 0 in it. The previous register, the destination register, has 0 in it. Therefore, the 0 flag is affected. That's how the 6 has been come up over here. This you can test it for shift right. It works the same. But when it is the second type of instruction, that is this one, let me stop the debug session. Now I am giving 32. This will shift a bit 32 times. This will also take away 1 from the carry flag. Therefore, the carry flag will also be 0 after executing this instruction. Let me save this, build, and start the debug session. See, this has R1 has become 0. Because the R1 content has been shifted 32 times, it became 0. Therefore, only 0 flag is set. That is how it is 4. Means, if 0 flag is set over here, this 4 bit value will give you 4. That is how it is 4 over here. This was about LSL and LSR instruction. So, this was it in this video. In the next video, I am going to teach you about ASR, that is arithmetic shift right, and rotate instruction ROR, and also arithmetic shift left. So this is it. See you in next video. Bye.